Jetpacks, Baby Groot, a new member of the team. Yes, it's not even Comic-Con yet, but Marvel is already in play with our first look at Guardians of the Galaxy 2. Well, concept art, but we'll take it, especially because there are a couple of reveals here. I think everyone's, of course, is going to pay attention to the new character here, Mantis, played by Pom Klementieff. But I want to talk first about the jetpacks and, of course, Baby Groot. Then we'll be able to dive into Mantis in detail. And she deserves it because there are some interesting aspects to the character which I think would particularly appeal to James Gunn. But anyway, the jetpacks are great. At first I was like, is that some kind of body armor on Peter Quill? Because the jetpack propulsion blended in really well to that explosion behind them. Explosions! I hope they have some explosion jokes. That would be hilarious in the movie. But then you can see Rocket Raccoon flying there in the background wearing a similar device, so it looks like those two characters will be airborne. You know, Peter Quill had like rocket boots in the first movie, but I guess he's upgraded, or at least he and Rocket Raccoon want to match. But anyway, and also you can see Yondu is either pursuing the team because he has reason to be upset with them at the end of the last movie, or perhaps has joined them. And Nebula there is there for some reason. This is concept art. I don't know how much I would take it to being telling you anything about the story that's coming up. But still, interesting to see them all part of the group. But Baby Groot, Baby Groot! Oh, what a genius idea to have Baby Groot for at least a good chunk of the movie. Now, what's interesting is they were talking to the producer about the film. I guess James Gunn is going to hold his comments for Comic-Con. But the producer said, you know, with Baby Groot, the question is this a younger version of Groot and he just has to mature again every time that he, you know, is reborn? Or is this a seedling of Groot and it is basically child of Groot, Groot's offspring? But I think that's really interesting. That's an interesting idea. One that I'm sure will plague Rocket Raccoon, Groot's buddy. But also, I'm really interested to see what Groot does. They said he's going to be very mischievous, very immature, and I think that's going to be even cuter and more adorable. Although, if he's so little, I don't know what he can really do to help the team besides make it cuter, but we'll see. We'll see. He certainly looks like he is more part of the action than he ever was when he was an adult giant Groot. So anyway, this new character we have here is Mantis, again, as I said, played by French-Canadian actress Pom Klementieff. And, you know, whenever you add a new character to the team, it always pulls focus. And I think that both Zoe Saldana's Gamora and Karen Gillan's Nebula are going to have to work really hard to hold on to their territory in the film. Especially because Mantis seems to have some really cool aspects to her character. And as you can see, Gamora has a new costume, I guess maybe to help her out. I actually like her costume for the first film a little bit better. This one's a little pirate-like. I think they're trying to make her seem more of an equal with Peter Quill. But I think for some reason, I don't know, it seems a little bit more mature, a little bit less fun. But she's got her sword, although now DC has their sword-wielding heroine as well, Wonder Woman, who is going to get a lot of attention at Comic-Con as well. Another video on her, actually, later today. But back to Mantis. Mantis, funnily enough, I was doing some checking this morning on her. She was ranked 99th out of 100 on a recent Sexiest Women in Comics guide. So she just made the list. It's a little bit like 99 out of 100. But anyway, I was like, so who did she beat out, right? So she beat out Harlequin, but not Harley Quinn, another character with a similar name from DC's comics of old. And this was a character named Molly Maine, who eventually married Alan Scott, aka the Green Lantern of the time, to become Molly Maine Scott. So this character was actually first created in 1947. So what? Maybe Paul Dini isn't such a genius. No, of course he is. But you know, you have to wonder if he got maybe a little bit of inspiration from that, or at least the DC, you know, legal department was like, well, you got to split the name into Harley Quinn because Harley Quinn's already taken. But anyway. In the comics, Mantis is a half Vietnamese, half German prostitute. And the Kree end up believing that she will be the celestial Madonna, which is basically Space Mary, Mother of Jesus, right? So basically, they've combined Mary and Mary Magdalene, right? So the two Marys have become one in a Vietnamese-German prostitute who will give birth to the celestial Messiah, which she will have by mating with a race of plants. You know, you can see why James Gunn is the right director for this material. It's just so campy and crazy. But anyway, her abilities include being an expert martial artist to the point that she can also have control different aspects of her body, from her breathing to her heart rate to her ability to heal. So she's basically like a super ninja. She is also a psychic empath, which means she can sense others' emotions, and she can also project her consciousness onto the astral plane. Does Marvel still own the cinematic rights to the astral plane, or did Fox get those in the agreement? But anyway. So that's her psychic abilities, and then she can also communicate and control plants, so she and Baby Groot will probably get along. But the ability that I'm the most interested in is that in the recent Annihilation Conquest storyline, she had the ability to see the future, a little bit like Ulysses right now in Civil War II. It's funny how these certain abilities keep popping up. But anyway, I think it'd be interesting if Mantis could see the future and perhaps could see the Infinity War that's coming down the pipeline. So that would, if I were James Gunn, that would be a power that would be hard for me to resist in the considering the wider scope of the MCU. But I think the thing that I actually like the most about Mantis is how close she looks to the comic book version of the character. Sometimes she's had green skin. Obviously she can't because of Zoe Saldana's Gamora, but she's also sometimes not had green skin. And, you know, this is just the concept art, but, you know, they've made an effort to, you know, mimic the actual faces of the actors playing these characters. And if Pom Klementieff really looks that much like Mantis, that's pretty impressive. So anyway, what do you think of this first look at Guardians of the Galaxy 2? Stay tuned, I'm sure, for much more information coming out of Comic-Con next week, which I will be sure to cover here on Beyond the Trailer. All right, thanks for watching. Bye.